Dyer, the freshman back, runs 4-6 to the 46. He was tackled by Eddie Pleasant. No, he wasn't. He's still on his feet at the 40. 35, 30, down the sideline to the 23. He was pulled down on top of Pleasant. Everybody stopped except for Dyer.
I was being tackled, but I kind of landed on top of him. You know, my knee wasn't down, but I didn't hear a whistle on that yet, so I was kind of looking like, you know, what's going on. But then I hear, you know, Darwin come on, and the team's going, let's go, and I was trying to run, get some extra yards to keep the ball in bounds and get the first down.
We've done that every day for the last 4.5 weeks, where he's got to make the game-winning field goal in practice with everybody giving him every distraction known to man, and he does it every day.
Cam Newton Jr., everyone predicted a high-scoring shootout, but you said throughout the key matchup in this game was going to be your defensive front against their offensive line. How did that bear out in this game?
Well, let me tell you what. First of all, I just can't be more blessed to be a part of a whole team like this. Man, God was with us. Our defense played outstanding today. We knew they were going to play outstanding today. We worked our rear end off all month long. This is for the Auburn fans. This is for the Auburn family. I couldn't be more proud of everybody involved. I love everybody. War Eagle.
Gene, from where you were 2 years ago, everything you endured when you left Iowa State to this moment, what does this moment mean to you, given that journey?
Look around. Look around. It's all about the fans. It's all the people that stuck with us through thick and thin. We got the greatest fans in the country. We got the greatest administration in the country. We got the best players in the country. It's not about me. It's about Auburn University today.
Finally, G to G, your motto this season. You were good last season. You wanted to be great this season. What made that happen?
I think it was our coaches, our players, a sense of chemistry of our team that I've never seen before. Today, I can tell you this, we're the best football team in the United States of America, and War Eagle.
Congratulations, Gene. Cam Newton, heading into that final drive, score tied, less than 3 minutes to go. What did you tell your team in that huddle?
Everybody was just staying calm. You know, we've been through this before. And, you know, we had to execute the plays that coach was calling, and we had to stay calm and just execute.
You have had so much adversity. This team has come from behind, but you personally, you fought through it. You've maintained your focus throughout. How would you describe your own journey from Blinn when you left there to get here?
You know, it's just a God thing. You know, I thank God every single day. You know, I'm just his instrument, and he's using me on a consistent basis daily. You know, I just want to, you know, he's using me to extend his word. And I'm a prime example of how God can turn something that was bad into something that was very great.
What did this season teach you about you, your family, what you believe that you didn't know before it happened?
Anything is possible. I guarantee you 5 or 6 months ago, nobody would have, you know, betted their last dollar to say that Auburn University is winning the national championship. But now, on January 10, 2011, you know, we're smiling right now saying, you know, we did it.
National champions for the first time in more than half a century. Cam Newton, congratulations.